as a dentist to the point. This is Dr. Saloni Jain, and in this video we'll be dealing with the fundamentals of tooth preparation or cavity preparation. Now this is a very important topic as it is the basic for your operative or conservative dentistry. So please listen to it carefully, because if the basics are clear, then you're sorted. Okay. So firstly, what is tooth preparation? So it is mechanical alteration of the defective, injured or diseased tooth such that placement of a restorative material re-establishes normal form, function and aesthetics where needed. Okay, so definition is very simple. That is, you alter or you do any alteration or you do any changes in the cavity, that is the defective or diseased part of the tooth, in the area where there is cavity, you do any change there and you place a suitable restorative material so that the normal form function of the tooth is established. So definition is simple. Now, tooth preparation are of three types, that is simple, compound and complex. What does a simple tooth preparation mean? So when the tooth preparation involves only one surface, so that is a simple one. For example, sieve occlusal surface involved there. So that is a simple one. When the tooth preparation involves two surfaces, that's a compound one. For example, occlusal bhi involved hai plus mesial involved hai. Jaise ki usko aap bolte ho mesio occlusion. Ya fir occlusion involved hai aur uske saath distal involved hai. To usko aap bologe distal occlusion. Okay, any of the two. Third is complex. Matlab more than two surfaces are involved. For example, occlusal bhi hai, mesial bhi hai and distal bhi hai. So, three surfaces involved hai. So, that is complex. Actually, the surface involved, you take the initial of that letter. Okay. So, agar main bolu compound mein, so MO, that means mesio occlusal hai. Matlab, that's a compound tooth preparation. If I say MOD, that's a mesio occlusal distal preparation. That's a complex preparation. Now, I'll give you an example. For example, this is your tooth. Okay. So, this is your tooth. Now, this is the whole of the tooth. This is your occlusal surface, mesial surface, distal surface, buccal surface, lingual surface. So normal, this is a tooth. Now, if this is the occlusal surface and if I remove the occlusal surface, okay, so this is a simple tooth preparation. Only one surface is involved, so this is a simple tooth preparation. Now, I remove the mesial surface. So this is a compound tooth preparation. Okay, this is a compound tooth preparation. Now, I remove the distal surface as well. Now, as you see, the three surfaces are removed. Namely, your mesial, your occlusal, your distal, whatsoever you say. So, three surfaces are removed. Now, this is known as a complex tooth preparation. One surface, simple. Two surface, compound. Three surfaces, complex. Moving on to the walls. Now, these are the terminologies which are very important for the tooth preparation point of view. So, if this is a tooth, okay, now this is a tooth, for example, this is your mesial wall, this is, peeche wala is your distal wall, this is your lingual wall and this is your buccal wall. So, this is the tooth with your distal, mesial, labial and, lingual and buccal walls. Okay, this is a tooth. Isko 3D jaise imagine karo thoda sa. So, if this is a tooth and actually, I have not told you what is a class 2 preparation or what is an MO preparation, but you just take an example ki mesial wall ko hata diya hai and we have made a class 2 cavity. By default, you have made involving a cavity, you have made a cavity involving the occlusal and the mesial walls. Okay. So now there are two types of wall. Okay. So first wall are the internal walls, second is the external walls. External walls kya hui? That extend to the external tooth surface. Okay. Internal wall kya hui? That are present within the tooth or that do not extend to the external tooth surfaces. So external walls are simple. Okay. That extend to the external tooth surface and they take the names of the wall which are present adjacent to them. For example, this is the tooth. Now this is the tooth. So, agar ye uska distal wall hai, to ye ho gaya uska distal. Matlab, this is the distal surface. So the wall present here is distal wall. Agar yahan par mesial wall hota, so that could be a mesial wall. Okay. Agar ye hai, this is your lingual wall. This is your buccal wall. So these are the external walls. And lastly, the one that is present here is a gingival one. You can say it a gingival seat or a gingival floor or a gingival wall. That's a type of an external wall. Also, an internal wall is one that does not extend to the external tooth surface. So the pulpal walls and the axial wall. Now the pulpal wall is the one that is obviously this wall, matlab ye aapka tooth hai. Or jo pulp ke upar wall hoge, that is going to be the pulpal wall. The confusing one are the axial wall. The axial wall is one, always remember this line, that axial wall is one that is parallel to the long axis of the tooth. अगर ये दांत है तो उसके पैरेलल जो वॉल आएगी, तो ये दांत की ये पैरेलल वॉल हुई, तो एक्सियल वॉल इज पैरेलल टू ऑलवेज द लॉन्ग एक्सिस ऑफ द टूथ. एंड योर जिंजाइवल सीट इज ऑलवेज परपेंडिकुलर टू द ऑक्लूजल सरफेस ऑफ द टूथ. गॉट द कॉन्सेप्ट? नाउ आई पॉप अ स्मॉल वीडियो, सो हैव अ लुक एट दैट वीडियो सो दैट यू गेट अ क्लियर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ ऑल द वॉल्स.
ओके, सो नाउ फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिस इज अ टूथ एंड दिस इज अ क्लास टू कैविटी प्रिपेयर्ड. You will get to know later in the video what is the meaning of class 1, class 2, class 3 cavities. Abhi, you just take into consideration that this is a class 2 cavity prepared. Okay. So now, the walls which we are going to discuss, which we have discussed theoretically here, practically as you can see. For example, if this is the distal surface of the tooth, this is the buccal surface, this is the lingual surface. Okay. And this was the mesial surface, which because of the cavity has extended. So we have removed the mesial wall here. Okay, so now here, now as this is the distal surface, so this wall becomes the distal wall. So this wall becomes the distal wall. Okay, now as the mesial wall is not present here, so the mesial wall is not there. Okay, now this is the distal wall. So here we have our lingual wall. So this green one becomes the lingual wall. Okay, another, since this is the buccal surface, so this wall becomes the buccal wall. So the orange wall becomes the buccal wall. Now, since this is the pulpal floor, as you can see here, now this is the pulpal floor of the cavity. Okay, so this is called as the pulpal floor of the cavity. Now, mesial wall has been removed because of the class 2 preparation here. So as you can see, the wall that is parallel to the long axis of the tooth. Okay, now this is the tooth. So this is going to be the parallel axis. Okay, so this is the tooth and this is going to be the parallel axis. So the wall that is present to the parallel axis of the tooth, now this, that is this, this is known as the axial wall. Okay, this is known as the axial wall. So this is the axial wall of the tooth. Okay, and this, which is perpendicular to the gingival surface, this which is perpendicular to the occlusal forces. Okay, so this is known as the gingival seat or the gingival wall. So this is about the walls. This is the basic about the wall. The walls, these are the external walls which take their name from the surface they are touching. This is the distal wall, this is the lingual wall, this is the buccal wall, this is the pulpal floor. Here we have the axial wall, which is parallel to the long axis of the tooth, and the gingival seat, and this being the gingival seat, which is perpendicular to the normal occlusal masticatory forces applied, or to the normal occlusion. So this is all about the walls.
So I hope that after watching the video, you are clear with the wall, that which wall is called which wall, and you're not confused no more about it. So moving on to the next term, that is your cavo surface angle or the cavo surface margin. Now what is this? It is nothing but a junction, okay, where your prepared tooth surface and your external tooth surface meet. So it's nothing but a junction where the prepared, this is the prepared tooth surface and this is the external tooth surface, where these two meet. The angle which is formed there is known as your cavo surface angle or the cavo surface margin. So this, within the prepared tooth surface and external tooth surface, the angle formed, the junction they meet, the angle they form at there is known as the cavo surface angle or the cavo surface margin. Next, we are going to see the classification of tooth preparation, which is very important, the G.V. Black's classification. Moving on to the G.V. Black's classification of tooth preparation, that is Green, Wardyman, Black's classification of tooth preparation, which is very important. He has divided them into 5 types, class 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, and later a 6th class was also added. Okay, so let's see them one by one. First is class 1, that is the pit and fissure sealants, which involve 3 things. First is occlusal surfaces of the molars and the premolars. Second thing, occlusion 2/3 of the facial or lingual surface of the molars. Third thing, lingual surfaces of the incisors. Got the concept? Moving on to the second one. So it involves the proximal surfaces of the molars and the premolars. Preparations involving the proximal surfaces of the molars and the premolars. Moving on to the third one. So here it is preparations involving the proximal surfaces of the anteriors without involving the incisal edge. So the incisal edge is intact and the proximal surface is involved. Proximal as in mesial or distal surface. But the fourth one is key preparations involving the proximal surface with involving the incisal angle. Here without involving, either without hai, either with involving the incisal angle. Class 5, preparations on the gingival two-thirds. Okay, preparations of the gingival two-thirds of facial or lingual or palatal surfaces of all the teeth is class 5. Okay, and the newly added class 6 says that the preparations that involve the incisal edges of the anteriors or the cusp tips of the premolars and molars. These are very easy to understand. Now you can remember the trick as कि आप धीरे-धीरे नीचे जाते जा रहे हो. Class 6 को थोड़ा exclude कर दो. पहले आप occlusal पे थे, थोड़ा आप नीचे हैं proximally, फिर proximal पे चले, and then आप finally नीचे आ गए gingival पे. Sorry. So this is all about the G.V. Black's classification. So now we are going to discuss what is a line angle and what is a point angle. So very simple definition yet confusing sometimes. So line angle is nothing where two different surfaces, okay, now two surfaces of different orientation meet. Where two surfaces of different orientation meet forms a line angle, okay. And what's a point angle? That is where three different surfaces of different orientation, where three surfaces of different orientation meet, that forms a point angle. So line angle, when two surfaces of different orientation meet, point angle, when three surfaces of different orientation meet. Now, according to the cavity preparations like class 1, class 2, there are different point angles and line angles formed, okay? So, I'll tell you one basic how to see now what are the names and what is that. You don't have to go into the details of each line angle and point angle. The important is that you have to remember this. You need to remember this table. Ki kis mein kitne line angle or point angle hote hai. But I'll explain you one basic ki kya hota hai, kaise hota hai. Now imagine this as a tooth. Okay, now this is a tooth. This is a class 1 preparation involving the occlusal surface of a molar. Okay, so this is a tooth. This is the buccal or the facial surface. This is your mesial surface. This is your lingual surface. And this is your distal surface. And inside you have your pulpal floor. Okay, so this is a tooth which has class 1 preparation. Class 1, AP surface involved hai, occlusal surface involved hai. So this is a class 1 preparation. Now, as I said that a line angle is nothing where two different surfaces of different orientation meet. So this is the buccal surface, this is the mesial surface. So this buccal and lingual surface, they meet. So this is a line angle. Where buccal, this is the lingual, this is the mesial surface, this is the facial surface. So where these facial and the mesial surface meet, this forms first line angle known as your mesiofacial line angle. Similarly, this mesial surface makes a line angle with this lingual surface known as mesiolingual line angle. Similarly, this mesial surface makes an angle with the pulp known as mesiopulpal line angle. 1, 2, 3. Similarly, with the distal surfaces, distopulpal, distofacial, distolingual. So, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 3 of mesial, 3 of distal, that makes your 6 line angles. Okay. Now, two more line angles are formed if you look carefully. That is buccal surface with the pulp, that is your faciopulpal, and lingual surface with the pulp, that is your lingvopulpal. So, in all, you have 8 line angles. 8 line angles. Now, got the concept how we have written 8 here? So, this is a cavity preparation, and you need to imagine as you do in your practicals also, there also you learn. So, this is how you get 8 line angles. Now talking about the point angles that are formed. Now point angle is what? Nothing where three surfaces of different orientation meet. This is the buccal surface. This is the mesial surface. This is the pulp. So they all meet here. That here the point forms is a point angle. So what is going to be called as facio-mesio-pulpal point angle? Sorry, mesio-facial or whatsoever. So mesio-facio-pulpal point angle. Similarly, mesio lingvopulpal point angle, distofaciopulpal point angle, distolingvopulpal point angle. So how many point angle? 4 point angle. Got the concept? The two surfaces meeting forms a line angle, the three surfaces meeting forms a point angle, and this is how you name the line angles and the point angles. Now I have told you with an example here, so you are very clear that class 1 preparation has 8 and 4. Class 2 has 11 and 6. I'll pop diagram of the line angles and point angles for each class here. For class 2, I'll pop where you will see 11 line angles and 6 point angles. Okay. For class 3, you will see 6 line angles and 3 point angles. Now you see the pattern. Now this is reversed. So you need to remember 3. That is 8, 4, 11, 6, 6, 3. Then it's reversed. Again 11, 6, 8, 4. तो यहां तक आपने याद किया उस मतलब ये जो ऊपर के दो है वो नीचे के दो हो जाते हैं, जो सेकंड है वो सेकंड लास्ट है, जो फर्स्ट है वो लास्ट है. तो आपको सिर्फ इतना याद रखना है 8 11 6 11 मतलब आप समझ रहे 8 4 11 6 6 3 एंड देन इट इज रिवर्स्ड एज अगेन दैट इज 11 6 एंड 8 4. सो दिस टेबल हैज टू बी रिमेंबर्ड. दिस कैन बी आस्क्ड एज अ वाइवा क्वेश्चन आल्सो. दिस कैन आल्सो कम एज योर पीजी एंट्रेंस एग्जाम एमसीक्यू क्वेश्चन. So this is an important question and this you have to rectify थोड़ा बहुत. तो बाकी थोड़ा सा मैंने आपको ट्रिक बता दिया कि ये रिवर्स हो जाता है तो ऐसे करके ये टेबल ऐसे बना के आप रखोगे तो यू विल रिमेंबर. ओके, यू डोंट हैव टू लर्न द इंडिविजुअल लाइन एंगल एंड पॉइंट एंगल नेम्स. ओके, सो यू जस्ट हैव टू लर्न द कॉन्सेप्ट व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ लाइन एंगल एंड पॉइंट एंगल. सो यू विल ऑटोमेटिकली गेट. ओके, सो दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट टूथ प्रिपरेशन पार्ट वन. In the next part, we'll study the steps of tooth preparation, the initial and the final ones. Okay? So, if you understood this video, please like, share and subscribe. Also, hit the bell icon so that you're notified every time we upload a video. Thank you so much.